Hello, everybody. It's Quentin here from Professionally Inept, here with part two of my Portal 2 full play. Left off just after Wheatley popped off his rail, so let's jump right into it.
You up to speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're going to have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us.
I remember this hallway.
Awake.
Remember, I pointed out that we'd see this hallway again, and here it is.
Forever. That's an option. Option A, sit here, do nothing. Option B, go through there, and if she's alive, she'll almost certainly kill us.
So this guy's been here for, like...
Okay, I'm gonna lay my cards on the table. I don't want to do it. I don't want to go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. She's off. Don't panic over it.
Long-ass time, and he's never noticed that she's off?
There she is. What a nasty piece of work.
It's your ass. There she is. It kicked her ass.
Proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end?
If you remember last part, I mentioned Hoopy the Hoop.
I know, I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there was a long chunk of time where
Hoopy the Hoop.
Absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us escaping there, so that's pretty much the whole
they
story.
They wanted
don't touch him.
To become a meme, it didn't. And he also just talked about the guy who came in and defeated GLaDOS, so he didn't know, he doesn't know it's us. Whatever. Man. Drop you down here. Cout.
Okay, down these stairs.
Yep.
Jump! This actually. Ah! Oh, still held! Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grit. We're all fine. That's tremendous.
Still. Wait. Okay, never mind, sorry. Where am I going?
I just looked down. I do not recommend it. I've just done it again.
It's just gray. I'm like, what is there even to worry about at this point, you know?
This is the main breaker room. Look for a switch that says escape pod. Alright, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else.
Aperture science.
Just look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something and it doesn't say escape pod, look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't... You understand? Can you see it anywhere? I can't see it anywhere. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on.
Will you?
Let there be light. That's, God. Quoting God. Oh, look at that. Turning. Ominous. But probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, you know, moving up.
Wait.
No.
Oh, no.
Escape pod. It's moving up.
You idiot. Okay. You idiot.
Okay.
Wheatley,
no,
you
don't
idiot.
Worry. I've got it. This should slow it down.
No, oh, my God.
Go faster. Uh-oh.
Turn everything on.
Power up initiated.
Okay, don't panic. All right, stop panicking.
Really?
I still stop this.
I shouldn't be panicking, huh?
Not a problem. A.
You idiot.
Wait, did I do B? Did I do our head? Start writing these down.
Power up, complete.
Okay, listen. All
you
right,
buffoon.
Nothing. Hello!
Oh, it's you.
You know her?
It's been a long time. How have you been? I've been really busy being dead. You know, after you murdered me.
You did what?
Ow.
No.
And the portal gun fell.
Okay, look. We both said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I think
Wheatley.
Our differences
no.
behind us.
Nope.
For science. You monster.
Well, I mean...
I will say, though, that since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to test. I love it, too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first.
There is. Alright, and we're in the, back to square one portion. And what all this shit? No, it curves. No. Nah.
incinerator room. Be careful not to trip over any parts of me that didn't get completely burned.
All right, I get it. You're bitter. Now, if you do fall in there, you will die.
The portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like old times.
I think I found an old portal device.
Hold on.
I only had one. And like, this is where my... Or maybe this is mine.
Good.
This must be like the...
There should be a way back to the testing area.
My old one. That just kind of like fell down here and... I don't know. I'm sure there's more than one portal,
you know. Starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing yet. This will be our only chance to talk.
Mm-hmm. So what's new?
Here, let me get that for you. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quick save feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure,
great.
The last 2 minutes of my life are preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to relive you killing me again and again, forever. You know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge.
I am.
Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and
Thank
get
you.
Back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do it. More or less. I don't have
60,
the actual
Chell's like, what, 20?
In front of me.
Boop. Yay. Wait, what is... Oh. I think there's anything in here. I mean... Oh, see if it's test number 19.
I'll just move that out of the way for you.
Thank you.
This really is a wreck. But the important thing is you're back. With me. And now I'm on to all your little tricks. So there's nothing to stop us from testing for the rest of your life.
Wait, what's down
After
here?
After that, who knows? I might take up a hobby. Reanimating the dead, maybe.
Is there nothing down here? Really? Okay. Well, this was the hallway. That originally took you down, I guess he... Where did it just come from there? Yeah, I just came from there. What am I doing? Yep. Oof. Kinda cleaned up. Remain calm. Man. Wait. What? Oh, okay. Oh, right, sorry.
I
was a little tutorial on lasers or something.
By the way, thanks for that.
Sarcasm self-test complete.
Oh, good. That's back online. I'll start getting everything else working while you perform this first simple test, which involves deadly lasers and how test subjects react when locked in a room with deadly lasers.
Then fire the laser! Right. So, you're gonna wanna be on here. Let me do that. It's cause it won't come back down for you.
Not bad. I forgot how good you are at this. You should pace yourself, though. We have a lot of tests to do.
Whoopsie daisy! Aperture science. GLaDOS is still alive for some reason.
This next test involves discouragement and direction cues. I just finished building them before you had your, well, episode. So now we'll both get to see how they work.
Great.
There should be one in the corner.
Yep. Oop. Nope. Yep. What does this do? Right. Okay. Oop. And now I can refract. Can't forget to. We always gotta get the security cameras. I love doing that. Get me some stairs. Oh, huh. I wonder, can I, Oh, yeah, even shit like that will. Ow, ow, ow. Ow. Unlock the, laser. Yep. Well, thank you.
Well done. Here come the test results. You are a horrible person. That's what it says. A horrible person.
Does it really say that?
We weren't even testing for that.
Nope. There we go. Yay. Real fun part of this game.
Don't let that horrible person thing discourage you. It's just a data point.
On its way.
If it makes you feel any better, science has now validated your birth mother's decision to abandon you on a doorstep.
Hey, and we are here. We're, oh my god. I wonder if I was standing on there if it would have taken me out. I don't know. Maybe that security camera knows. It didn't. Right, now down here is, oh look, another rat man. Dan, right, nothing especially special vilify. What is that? This isn't that funky, spiced up version of Still Alive. No, this is Exile Vilify, written by, I think it's The National. And, they didn't just pick a song. The National actually wrote and recorded this song specifically for Portal 2, which is pretty goddamn cool. Let me just double check. I downloaded the song as soon as I found that out. Yeah, The National. So if you want, you can just kind of hang out here, listen to the song. It's a good, pretty good song. Be sure to take that with you. You don't want to do this level without it. Look at all these cans. I know a certain someone who'd be very happy. But yeah, be sure to take this with you as far as you can. Because the farther you get, the less you can hear the song. Shit. No. Oh. And, this song only plays on this. Sorry, I like listening to it. On this one level, actually, so, it's just, Let's leave it by the door so we don't forget it. Security camera out here. Watch that, make sure no one takes it. Can I make this? Oh, wow, I did not honestly expect to make that. Whoops. Alright. Boosh. Don't even try, yeah. It's a good song. Definitely worth a listen. Where was that other one? Ah, there it is. On the, fucking roof. Alright. Get out of the way of the door. Holy shit. I'm right there.
Congratulations. Not on the test. Most people emerge from suspension terribly undernourished. I want to congratulate you on beating the odds and somehow managing to pack on a few pounds.
I might just, I suppose you can just look it up, but if you, I guess I could just, like, leave, if I remember to, I might leave a link to the iTunes download for this song. It's not, like, upbeat or anything, but it's just kind of a nice, peaceful, relaxing song, you know? Alright. That was a nice song, well lasted. I don't care. Just burn it. Alright. Aperture science. That's a problem. Guy waving. What's this one?
One moment.
Never trust red carpets, they fall apart.
You are navigating these test chambers faster than I can build them, so feel free to slow down and do whatever it is you do when you're not destroying this facility.
Oh. Alright. That's deadly. Deadly lasers. Ow. That was dumb. Right. Should have been over there. So yeah, you want to throw up this orange one, and then you'll want to go over here and go blue. And that starts that lift. What is this? Oh. Grab this lovely cube. Kinda, you can jump it, or you can just kinda like let yourself get here and then just kinda block the laser, get past it, let it go again.
I'll give you credit. I guess you are listening to me. But for the record, you don't have to go that slowly.
Ah, piss off. Go and play fast. All right. I'm gonna start clearing stuff off. Don't have much room left on my okay, I'm just trying to make sure my audio's still running, and it is. All right. I'll try to talk louder. I have a tendency to talk quietly sometimes, especially since it's, I'm in my room and, you know, people are asleep. Oh, okay.
This next test involves the Aperture Science aerial faceplate. It was part of an initiative to investigate how well test subjects could solve problems when they were catapulted into space. Results were highly informative.
Ooh, never done this before. What is this? What about this? Can I? Boosh! That was fun. What is this, a cube? Oh, right, you gotta... Hup, ooh, nope, missed it. Time it. Get it. Yes, nice. Oh, that was way better than last time.
Here's an interesting fact. You're not breathing real air. It's too expensive to pump this far down.
Long-distance camera.
We just take carbon dioxide out of a room, freshen it up a little, and pump it back in. So you'll be breathing the same room full of air for the rest of your
She's
life.
Trying to discourage me. She thinks it's going to get me down, but it's not. Well, I mean, if it were really me, that could be a little sad, I guess. The breathing the same air the rest of my life.
Let's see what the next test is. Oh, advanced aerial faith plates.
Oh, that's safe.
Well, have fun soaring through the air without a care in the world.
Not sure that works, huh?
I have to go to the wing that was made entirely of glass and pick up 15 acres of broken glass by myself.
All right. What was that? I got a blue dot. Nope, crouching, bad idea. She's gonna... Oh my god. Alright, I'm glad we got this on the second video. We get to the best and most important part. Or, well, Easter egg anyway. Go over here. Go over here. Shoot. Shoot! Oh, that was freaking top notch. Now, I'm not gonna risk it. Oh. Alright, I'm just gonna save the game manually in case I need to, because this, you get one shot. At this. So,
Oh, sorry.
She says, whoopsie daisy, there's trash in here.
So sometimes there's still trash in
them. And you leave those portals there. If you move them, this is over. You can see a ball, a turret. Security camera, a ball. You don't see it when it's flying, it's weird, but. See if you can't. There it goes. Don't fall in the water. Okay, it's fine. Leave the orange. Okay. You get. There's some cool stuff. You a disc, you can't do anything with that.
It's garbage.
Poosh.
Press the button again.
Water jug. Do the water jug. Alright, throw up a blue portal. And you're thinking, what? It's just another radio. It can't be that important, right? Boop. Put that there. What am I? Oopsie daisy, what am I doing? Ah! Right, alright. Throw that down there. Kind of climb up. Oh. How am I? How did I? Screwed this up. Alright, that's fine. Grab this. Hop on through. Put that down for now. You're gonna wanna pop, of course, the first one there. But the second one, you're gonna wanna pop it. There. Okay. And just proceed normally. Alright, here we go. Oop. Oh, made it. Uh-oh. Oh my god, no. Oh my god, no. No. Get out of here. Are you shitting me right now? Get over here, you turd. Jesus. Now I'm gonna put it down for a sec, do the look around first. Look, it's Hoopy the Hoop again, yay! More Ratman Doodles, Phases of the Moon. Oh, Smooth Jazz fails, yes it did. How did you know? Well, companion cubes and shit, but, here we go. You bring it in here. And it starts playing that noise, and you're like, ah, that's annoying, what is that? For those of you who might not know, there's a special kind of thing called SSTV, and it's used most commonly by, like, amateur radio operators to send pictures to each other, because it takes a picture and it kind of converts it into different frequencies, but within voice frequencies, so you can send it through a radio and someone on the other end can decode it, and you can basically send a picture through ham radio, which is pretty cool until email. Well, it was until email got invented. But I'm not going to bother trying to decode it on my own, because anytime I do it comes out crappy. I'm going to find, I know online that there's one that's almost perfect, and I'll just kind of like put that picture in the video. Basically what it is, it's this kind of peculiar photo of a companion cube on the moon. What could that mean? We don't know yet, but it has some sort of significance later, I suppose. So I'll just, I'll make a note, actually, in the game, like, in the video's name, to try and remind myself to throw in that picture. Or you can even try it yourself, but yeah, basically, this, unfortunately, didn't pop up, but this would have gotten you the, and like I said, I already played this game when I after downloaded it, so this would have gotten you the, final transmission achievement, find the hidden signal in one of Ratman's dens. So, yeah. Yeah, anyway. So, there you go. There it is. Weird little error. Little Easter egg here. Not much else to show you. More cans and shit. No, that's it. This is now useless to us. Goodbye. Alright. Whee! That was dumb. Alright, Orange, you want to get back over to where you were. Actually, you can just do that. You don't need to go through the whole launching thing. Oh, it's kind of fun. Nah, I'm not gonna bother. Alright, back up here. Boosh. Boom. Oh, no. Watch your step, guys. You, don't want to walk off the edge. It's not really, helpful. Ah, I kind of burnt it up, didn't I? So yeah, you want to throw one up there. The next companion cube is... Oh god, no. Whoopsie fucking daisy. Alright, you have to leave these portals up. My mistake. Boosh. Then drop this. Don't know why it's telling me to duck. That drops way over there. Way the fuck over there. Might as well catch it. Oh, that was beautiful. Alright. Drop one. There. And drop one there. Now, I'm not gonna go with it. Oh, thank Christ, because to be honest, I don't know if there's a way back. Oh, I mean, there's gotta be. I'm curious, let's find out. Like, oh no, I fell with it. I wanted to make sure it didn't land on the button. I had to fix it. Is there anything you can do here? Oh. Oh. No. This isn't good. Oh, you can just boop. Boosh. There we go. Alright, that was simple enough.
Remember before when I was talking about smelly garbage standing around being useless? That was a metaphor. I was actually talking about you.
Well, you're a bitch, GLaDOS, so, you know.
You didn't react at the time, so I was worried it sailed right over your head, which would have made this apology seem insane. That's why I had to call you garbage a second time just now.
Well, that is very much appreciated. I'm being 1000% honest. I really appreciate you explaining that, because... sarcasm. Alright,
I'm sorry. I don't know why that went off. Anyway, just...
Because I was talking over it. She basically says people with guilty consciences are startled by loud noises and then plays a train whistle. So, ha ha ha. She's implying I'm guilty. Anyway... I guess I'll call the video there, because I'm about a half hour in. I want to keep these nice and short. So thank you all for watching, and I'll, see you next week with part 3 of my Portal 2 full play. Alright.